basketball. They started hooing and cheering and being a Memphis fan. Now this year they don't like them so high, so they went back to their necessary corners. But see, if you understand that it is not given to the swift nor the battle to the strong, it doesn't matter what is going on, we are still winners. I am reminded of the scripture, amen, over in Kings where Elisha had, amen, upset his enemy. And the Bible says that on the morning his servant awoke and he was distressed. The Bible says because he saw that their enemy had surrounded them and encompassed them, amen, and come, amen, to find out that there were a lot more of the enemy seemingly than his servant and Elisha. Amen. Many times people don't understand where ministry is going, so they'll fight against what they don't understand. But Elisha, amen, talked to the Lord God and said, Lord, open my servant's eyes so that he can see that there are more that before us than there that are against us. Yes. The problem in today's Christian churches is that we walk by sight. We have sight realm where we see the doors are not filled, the pitches are not filled, and the offering starts to dwindle, and people, amen, start to, amen, walk out, amen, of the building, and things seem to be going wrong and going, amen, haywire. And so if we understand that the devil, amen, wants you to be fearful in the day of adversity, but the Bible says that we walk by faith and not by sight. I don't have 20/20 vision. I was told that Pop Dobbins in his 84 years got 20/20 vision. I don't even have 20/20 vision. Look at God. We ought to just shout right there. But many times we, amen, look at what's going on in our lives.
Yes, yes.
The devil will try to cause us to be fearful, but the Bible tells me in 1 Timothy, for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. So if there is fear, it has to have come from the devil. We've got to know that our enemy is there to fight us. Yeah. And the only thing that we are responsible for